Laravel Nightwatch is a new app created by the Laravel team that is designed to monitor your application. It's specifically designed for Laravel apps. You install it, it starts ingesting data, and you don't have to do anything else. It's pretty brilliant and pretty nice. I really like the idea behind Nightwatch. I also like the name. I haven't actually heard what it's named after. I think of, I guess, like a Batman or a superhero, Vin from Mistborn, if you read Brandon Sanderson. You know, it's just like this thing that watches out over your city and keeps an eye on things, make sure everything's running smoothly. And if anything happens, then it jumps in and tells you. But I like the name. I like the idea behind it. I think it's awesome. So let's start with installation. It was literally simple. Like, I was up and running in 2 minutes. You install a composer package. The Nightwatch website, once you create your new application, just gives you some variables that you copy and paste into your .env file. And then finally you run the Nightwatch agent, and you just want that running all the time. That's it. After that point, it just starts ingesting data, and it fills out your dashboard. First thing you'll notice, it's dark mode, which fits the theme of Nightwatch. I really like the design of this. I know design is subjective, but I like the dark and the contrasting colors of, you know, the orange up here in the charts and the green. I think they did a really good job about keeping it simple, but also, it's, in my opinion, it's pretty. So the dashboard, what it has is filters. So you can actually filter by 1 hour or 24 hours, 7 days, you know, 14, 30, whatever you need. This has been running on my site, the Laravel News website, for 3 days now. So we'll swap over to the 7 days so we can kind of get an aggregate, I guess, of what's been happening over the 3 days. So over 3 days, 132,000 requests, 130,000 of those were, proper requests, 2,000 were 404 errors, and we've had 2 500 errors. And then this gives you the duration as far as like the timing and things. We've had 2 exceptions reported in the last 7 days, 4 routes slower than 100 milliseconds, that way, or 1,000 milliseconds. And that gives you something to go look at, you know, in your own app. You can be like, well, those routes are slow. Let me go figure out why they're slow. 0 job attempts, 0 job duration. And if we scroll to the bottom, it says no users have been impacted by exceptions in the last 7 days. That's sort of misleading, but tricky to word it the right way, because I've had 2 exceptions. They've affected 2 people, but they were not logged in when it happened, so we have no record of who it actually affected. So we can't do anything there. But if they were logged in, it would have them right here, their user account, and then we can actually email them and, you know, get more data on what they were doing, or email them and tell them we fixed whatever the problem was, you know, anything like that. So that, to me, like, as a customer service standpoint behind your app, it would be really nice to just be proactive and email your people that might have had problems and be like, you know, we fixed it. Sorry you had the problem, whatever. Moving on, most active users in the last 7 days, and then just a list of authenticated users versus request. So pretty neat little overview here. Moving on to the next part, which are these 2 exceptions that have been reported. What happens in Nightwatch is when you hit an exception, it actually creates an issue. So you have your own little bug tracker here. You can see we have 1 exception, curl SSL connection timeout. In reality, we've had 2, but they were the same exception. So it's grouped them together. If we click into this, you can write a message up here. They have a really cool use case for AI, which is kind of giving you insights into what may have happened. You can see the full stack trace, and then you can see the activity that's been on this issue. Over on the right, these are kind of, I want to say, hidden links. They're clickable, but it's not immediately noticeable. So if you click open, you can, you know, open, resolved, ignored. You can set the priority. You can set who it's assigned to, and then when it was last seen and first seen. And you can also subscribe or unsubscribe, which that's helpful, you know, if you are working with your team on Nightwatch. So that way, if somebody else fixes the issue, you can get an alert to notifying you that it's been fixed. Moving on to activity. So you have all these different activity things we can watch for. I'm going to switch this back to 24 hours just so all these charts fill out nicely. So the first thing is you can actually, we'll sort by 1, 2, and 300 responses. And you can see our article page is the most popular. And then you can go to 400 and see this unmatched route is the most 404 errors. And then we can click into there, click back on 404 again, and you can kind of see all these like random things people are clicking on. So that's useful in the case of like trying to like pinpoint why you have some 404 errors or something like that. Finally, on this page, you can sort by the average time it takes. So you can see which routes are slow. For this one, the post to the register is slow. That gives me an idea. I should go take a look at that and see why it might be slow. I'm not exactly sure just looking at the chart, but there must be some reason inside there. And then you finally have this one on the far right. It's called P95. I don't know what that means, but I will research that. If you know, put them in the comments, because I've never seen that before. So for whatever that is the post register is the slowest, and then the package route is the second slowest. So we'll move on to jobs. I've had one job, which is article to package. You can see it's been queued 5 times, but hasn't actually been processed. So I have an error here, and that tells me I need to go look and figure out why this is not running. Commands, how many commands have run in the last 24 hours? App article share is my number one. And what that does is, you know, when we publish a new article on the website, it automatically shares it out to all the social media channels, to Telegram, to, I don't know, there's like 13 different places it shares it to. And that's what this command does. Exceptions, again, we have to go back to 7 days. You can see there's the last time I had an exception. Queries, I think this is going to be a big one, because this will help you find all the slow queries in your app. You can see how many calls they've had, like this from cache, because we do a lot of caching. It's had almost 700,000 calls to this cache query. But I think what's important here is your average and this P95. So you can see actually which queries are the slowest, and that gives you a chance to either go in and refactor, maybe add some better database indexing on certain tables, anything like that. Just gives you a kind of a quick overview. Hey, these are probably some errors or some issues that you need to take a look at. Going to notifications, we only have two, which is article publish notification, which runs off of that command we seen earlier, and a verify email, which would be just people, you know, registering on the site. Mail, I don't have any, because we don't use actually the mailer within Laravel itself. We use a third party for that, so that makes sense. And then any outgoing request, basically API calls from your app. From there, we have users, which I won't click on because I don't want to show any data. And then finally, logs, which you can see these are basically your Laravel logs. And here we have this is basically a standard Laravel log file, and it allows you to search your logs or filter by, you know, different errors or different, you know, statuses or levels. So that's basically the sort of the quick overview of Nightwatch. We don't know when it's going to come out yet. I've been trying this for a few days. It feels super solid, so I think they're close, but they are going to make an announcement at Laracon US in Denver in July. I think it's at the end of July. So be, you know, stay tuned for that. And I think, you know, my personal opinion, I think I'm going to run this on every Laravel app I create. It's just so nice to have this quick overview of everything. It's awesome that it's built specifically for Laravel. There's, you know, nothing you have to do, no headaches, no anything. You just install it and let it run, and it starts getting the data for you. So let me know, you know, in the comments, what do you think? Are you excited for Nightwatch as I am? You know, what are you looking forward to about it? Thanks for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day.